wrong way, wasn't he, in that match in the final in Singapore. So they have met each other very recently.
Shuttle, racket. Racket, shuttle for you. Shuttle. Service.
Well, Simon Santoso is it kind of like a player reborn, hasn't he? Former world number three, who dropped right out of the upper echelons of the rankings, but has worked his way back up absolutely brilliantly over the last few months. Started at the Malaysian Open Grand Prix Gold Event in Johor Bahru, where he won that, and then, as I mentioned already, came through qualifying and ended up winning the Super Series event in Singapore, outplaying world number one Lee Chong Wei. And it's amazing how it turned. He left the Indonesia team, turned pro, and that responsibility seems to have, well, he's reacted well to it, hasn't he, to say the least, at the age of 28, working his way back up, and player to be feared again. So who is he facing? Well, it's Sean Lee, another of the Hong Kong youngsters.
Singapore.
I should say, yes, indeed. 18 years of age, or 19, I should say. But as you can see, only four matches this year. But he's done well in some of the junior events. But really, this should be a golfing class in terms of who he's playing.
Yeah, of course, there's also the situation of that the match is over. Is this a bigger game for the for Lee than it is for Simon? I'm pretty sure that Lee would like to treat if he could get a win over Simon in his belt. And what is Simon thinking if he's getting too much work to do? Will he?
There's that meeting I was talking about. Very comfortable first game, wasn't it, for Simon? That was just a month ago. Much tighter in the second.
Ready to play.
Back in the chair. Who's the umpire in our first match? There's Kelly Hoare in the chair there as well.
Lee Kwan, thanks.
I do take what you mean in terms of who the bigger match, but I think Simon Santoso, the way he, you know, left the national team,
ladies
and
gentlemen,
his way back in, he's got a
on
point to
right,
prove again.
Indonesia, yeah, represented by Simon Santoso, and on my left, Singapore, represented by Lee Kwang Ting. Indonesia to serve, love all, play.
Well, it's been a renaissance for Simon Santoso.
Service over.
And it's not been that kind of badminton
one
that's got him
love
back up the world rankings. More like that. Finding
service
right
over
in the corner.
One, all.
Oh, good shot.
It's like many players who have struggled, there's been injuries. He's actually thought about resigning from the PBSI towards the end
one
of last year. He said, let's give it a go. Let's see how you go in the first two events of the year. Lost in the first rounds there, and it just seemed there wouldn't be a way. You know, the prospect of him playing in the Thomas Cup, it just seemed so improbable back in January.
Yeah, it did, yeah.
But look what's happened over the last couple of months.
Well, he looks good.
Three,
but
one.
He's always been a great player. And
but he lost his way, obviously. You
yeah
know. As I say, back injury doesn't help.
No, and it's happened to, you know, Sonny Dwi as well from Indonesia has had a lot of back problems. It's just something that's very difficult to cope with.
Service over. Two, three,
It helps Sean Lee, doesn't it, that he's been on court with this man.
Oh yeah, very recently, especially the second set and the last match he played against him. That means a little bit of the fears are going away.
He also played Tommy Sugiarto as well in the event in Indonesia back in September, the Grand Prix Gold event there. Lost again, but you know, there's a familiarity at least for him. It's not an unknown quantity.
No. He's got a good start here as well.
Service over. 4-3.
Third time now we've seen that cross smash. Very effective.
4-5.
Jumped so high and hit so hard. Seen some good smashes in this match.
Yeah.
The whole match. Singles and doubles. Seems like this venue where we're playing it is kind of...
Yeah, that's the talk, yeah. Yeah. It encourages attacking play.
It does. That's good for the viewers, it's good for us. That's the most interesting thing to watch. Yeah.
You see that quite often, and you can understand why. Although you can't say it's influencing the line call now, because of course.
Well, you can just challenge it. So, but still, we need. It's a thing that's gone away now from the game, and that's very good that you're trying to influence line just to what it's called. We've seen how many bad calls I've made over the last 2 days. So
you're a better commentator than Lion Judge, let's put it that way.
So you can just see by influence they are human. That means, you know, here you have maybe an Olympic medalist or somebody who's telling you, this is out. Well, how many in this world will sit and argue with him?
Sure.
And we're talking about centimeters that we've seen last 2 days on the Hawkeye. So I think it's good we have the Hawkeye in to get rid of it. It's gone away, that we don't see the players influence the line just that much. And every time they do it a little bit, it's good that the umpires are telling them to stop it. Oh, great smash.
8-5.
So how does it work then with Simon here? I mean, he left the Indonesian national training camp, he's gone on his own, turned professional if you like.
Service over.
But now he's kind of back in it.
9.
Because he's
I really don't get, it's happened before with other players, I really don't get it. At one point, Flam Dilempele and Heng Yang even left the country and played for England. And they were also pulled back to Indonesia because they were too successful. So I think
10-6.
It depends a lot on how well you're playing.
But it's good though that I don't think there was any animosity there when he left Simon anyway. It was just purely based on his form.
Oh yeah, yeah. I don't think there's any
11-6.
It wasn't on a bad note or anything. Yeah.
So why not bring him back if they're good enough?
Of course.
Play them.
And it just shows you that, you know, some players who maybe have fallen out with you, with the Federation, you could say that they should stay away if they started working well.
So pretty comfortable so far. Good performance from Simon Santoso. He leads Sean Lee by 11 points to 6.
Court 1, 20 seconds. Court 1, 20 seconds.
A little puff of the cheeks, but maintaining your focus, that's the key here. Yeah, Santoso just
11-6, play.
Stay focused and sharp and carry on playing the kind of badminton we saw from him in the first quarter of this match. Nicely done by Sean Lee there.
Over, 7-11.
You know, we say he's ranked 383 in the world, but I mean, it's not really a fair ranking because he's not played enough qualifying tournaments to have a proper ranking.
No.
So it is a little distorted.
Oh. Service over. 12-7. That changed.
Smash.
Time is over.
8-12. We're questioning whether he's racket across the line here.
That's over. He's got a point there.
Yeah. I think if it was, shall we say, a tighter match,
could have been called.
Yeah.
But it also even there, that was slow replay. It really is fast.
Yeah.
So maybe we can have a Hawkeye on the net as well.
I suppose you could, really.
Yeah, that could be fun, actually. It's not that often it happens, though, but
no.
Just to give it a fair game.
Nine. Service over. 10-14.
Oh, great lift. Good control.
Service over.
And he's done that well all match so far, hasn't he? He's got the his length on his shots down to a tee.
Look at that. Perfect. We haven't seen that many being able to control it on either side.
Yeah.
So just shows you that Simon's got that extra touch. And he's really good in these holes where there's a lot of drift, which Singapore, having played there myself, is famous for that. So that just tells you that he's good at it.
There we go again. Oh, given out.
Well, he's not going to challenge
it. 11-15.
Yeah, let's have a look again. I think it was just out.
Yeah.
But again,
that means it's probably in.
Like all his compatriots in this overall tie, Sean Lee just giving it his very best out there.
At no point have you seen any of them giving up. And I think that's
17,
a great 12, attitude to show everybody.
Yeah, really good spirit.
Yeah. Even though that they're overpowered in most of the matches, they haven't given up. Changes. Simon using the full court now, really making Lee run. This is hard already.
Ooh, got it wrong that time. Hasn't happened too often.
15, 18.
3 points in it now. Hardly time to press the panic button for Santos, but
press it halfway down.
I don't think the finger's even dangling just yet.
No.
15, 18.
I think he felt that rally as well. He worked really hard in that rally, so let's see if he's going to cope with that. Yeah. That's normally what
19,
you see when
15.
The stamina's not there, you're making the wrong choices. And Simon just made him run really hard and work for that point before this.
Yeah, you could see he was breathing pretty heavily there, Lee.
Service over. 16, 19.
Great disgust shot. Unbelievable.
Yeah, very clever.
Service over. 20. Game point. 16.
Look at that. And Lee's really fast. And he still can't get it.
Oh, lovely way way for Simon Santoso to wrap up this opening game.
First game won by Indonesia, 21-16.
A lovely disguised cross-court shot and then the smash to power it home, 21 points to 16. A good match though, Sean Lee has played his part in it too. But Simon Santoso, the player very much like his country on top here, looking good to make it a clean sweep. Simon will be on the whole satisfied with that performance. There's always things to work on, isn't there?
Court one, 20 seconds. Court one, 20 seconds.
So almost job done as far as Indonesia are concerned. Simon Santoso can complete the job here.
Second game. Love all. Play.
So can Sean Lee just keep this resistance going?
Well, we have to remember he's on the side now where... Oof. Great rally.
He moves around pretty quick, doesn't he?
Yeah, he does.
Oh, yeah. Yes.
And that's what I was going to say. We have to remember he's on the side now where
service
he
over.
Can control the drift, and
one,
that means he's, he can push it a little bit more on his defense and his shots. So let's see if he's going to take advantage of that. Great spin by Simon.
One, two.
Short and punished.
Yeah. As we've seen it today and also saw yesterday, the ones who get
three,
the net, the
one.
One that can get that spin shot in, will have a big advantage. So that's a big battle for the net going on, and we see that they play it constantly.
4-1.
Well, good start from Lee in Lee. This second game.
Four, one. It's over. 2-4.
A rare error from Lee in this second game.
It's over. 5-2.
Well, it's been a theme, really, hasn't it? In the overall tie, nothing's been completely straightforward. You look. You know, It's one of those things, you know, you look in the paper the next day, it's, you could probably read Indonesia 5, so Singapore 0. Well, that was so straightforward.
A sweep. Yeah, but it hasn't been.
Just been little spells, hasn't there, where Indonesians have been pushed. It's kind of good for them as well.
This young guy has got a got some good things going on. We're interested to follow him over the next couple of years. See if he can establish himself on the senior tour.
Yeah, well done.
And you can see he's using the drift. Just pushing Simon to the backcourt, and Simon can't really get through with his attack right now. So
that's a couple of times in this game where he's lobbed him.
Service over, 4.
Just can't get a run of points going here, Santos, can it?
8-4.
Quick to snap up the opportunity.
That is over.
9-6. Well, Tommy Sugiarto was forced to 3 games for a while. I thought maybe Rumbaka might
seven,
be forced to 3
nine.
Games. And, well, here we are again with Simon Santoso trailing here in this second game.
Yeah, it's a good call.
It was close last time, wasn't it?
Yeah. But, and this time he was aware of it, the umpire, so.
Could be an important point as well, really.
Yeah. Just playing some close net shots, Simon. He's going to have to work hard on this side. Especially when Lee's defense is like this.
Wide.
Service over, 10-7.
Over
8-10. 9-10. Service over, 11-9, interval.
So at the interval, Sean Lee has given himself a chance to push Santoso all the way. Of course, when they last played, it was Santoso that won the second game, 24-22 last month in Singapore. Maybe we're going to see a very tight second set like we saw there. We shall see. 11-9 to Lee as it stands in game two.
Court one, 20 seconds. Court one, 20 seconds. Thank you, coach.
Well, he's got to try and maintain this level, Sean Lee.
On court, please.
Pretty hot out there, breathing heavily. Well, Simon Santoso knew what he was facing here.
11, 9.
You've played your opponent so recently. It's all pretty fresh in the mind. Of course, he went on to great things that week in Sean Lee's homeland of Singapore.
Service over, 10-11. Service over, 12-10.
Well, I have to remember, from Santoso's perspective, it's a dead rubber. Got to try and treat it like it is, as it normally is, a knockout match. But the reality is, when he loses,
10.
It doesn't really matter that much.
No, but it maybe matters something for his confidence, and they're going to need him.
But his confidence should be sky high coming into it.
And if Lee can do something here, then what would other players think?
That's more like it.
I think he should use that some more, some of these cuts and sticks, instead of hitting hard all the time. Seems like Lee's just using the power against him. I don't really get why Simon is playing
11.
So close to the net all the time. He's lost all the rallies at the net. Needs to play the further into the court.
Service over, 12-14. Change.
Well, he's trailed the whole of this second game as Simon Santoso. And actually close the gap down to 1 point for a while, and he won't hear either.
Service over, 15-12.
Very impressive for Simon. I think that's the first clear we've seen somebody use from this side.
Yeah.
So that just shows you how good he is at controlling the drift, which explains why he could have a performance like that in Singapore. He was ready for the flat, Simon. And you can see Lee, he's breathing heavily again. So maybe the tempo is kind of setting in. He's looking for air. Who wouldn't?
Sure. He's Speedy Gonzalez around the court, isn't he? But. For a moment, that looked like it might land in.
It wasn't that foul as we normally see when somebody leaves it on the back court.
Really tight net shot that could have gone either way. It's gotten the way of Sean Lee, who maintaining this advantage in game two.
Service over, 15-17.
Three-point advantage still.
He's just showing it. He's playing so well at the net. I just can't understand 15. Why Simon's not trying to flick serve or a different serve. He's serving so he can come with his forehand every time and do that spin shot to the net. Ooh. It's a very smart move. He played it into the court. Just what we spoke about a few rallies ago, instead of playing it close, play it further into the court,
course,
lead to left.
Oh, another tight net shot, this time it goes Santoso's way.
18.
Hung there for a little while.
Yeah. This is a very, very crucial point. And then you had the variation of serve. And there you saw straight away. Maybe he hurt me. Instead of serving into that forehand all the time so he can spin it,
yes.
He served out to the side. Let's see if he comes up with something like that again. Maybe a flick serve or a serve into the tee, the middle line, where it's also difficult to spin from. This time he used the middle line. Forces Lee to push instead of playing the net. See that? He can't do his forehand spin shot from there.
Well, from 18-15 up, suddenly for the first time in this game, Sean Lee is trailing to Simon Santoso. And that's out, and suddenly it's match points. How quickly it can turn.
Yeah.
20.
Great tactic by Simon. Changing up in the serve. So taking Lee away from his game.
Wow, that was incredibly saved, wasn't it?
19,
by Lee there.
20.
And that's the kind of resistance Singapore have been showing all morning here in Delhi. Of course, it went to extra points in the second game the last time they met. Some more tight net shots, and it is going to extra points here.
20-0.
A little short with the lift, and well, 20 all now. Match point number 3.
Service over, 21, 20. Change.
Let's see if that serve to Lee's backhand. It's not going to come again. Take the advantage away from. From Lee.
Simon Santoso makes it a clean sweep for Indonesia, but he was made to fight by Sean Lee, as the whole Indonesian team have by their Singapore opponents here this morning. A really good test for one of the
match
teams
won by Indonesia,
that are favoured to go maybe all the way
16,
here.
22-20.
21-16, 22-20, Simon Santoso. But some nervy moments, particularly here at the end. But nothing that Lee could do as the shuttle came towards his body there. So Simon Santoso avoided what fate came the way of Tommy Sugiarto, which was a 3-gamer. Although for a while in that second game, it looked like it might go to a third. So Indonesia 5, Singapore 0, the final scoreline, with Sugiarto winning in straight games. A good match, wasn't it? It really was. And it started with that service fault by Simon Santoso, but the way he played in the first game was just very impressive. Still 16 points on the board for Sean Lee. But in the second game, well, Lee knew he had a real opportunity. First job done for Indonesia here. 5 matches, 5 victories. I saw a lot of good smashes throughout the morning. With some fine shots. This second game, well, proved a tougher test, with Sean Lee getting himself ahead and staying ahead right until the death. But eventually, Santoso was able to turn it around, or pretty late in the day, though. Match points were saved by Sean Lee. 2018 down. But eventually, at the third time of asking, he did get it done. There it was. 21-16, 22-20. So Singapore showing some great resistance all morning here in the Siri Fort Sports Complex. But in the end, it was Indonesia taking it by 5-0. Let's hear from one of their winners here, Simon Santoso. Mohamed Hassan, of course, and Hendra Seria.
5-0 up for Indonesia against Singapore. A happy captain for the day?
Yes, of course. So we do best in today, but I hope next match will better.
What do you have to say about going forward for the next two matches against in your group? Do you see tough contenders there?
Maybe tomorrow against with Nigeria. I hope Indonesia wins, and then against Thailand, I hope Indonesia only win in the top group.
Indonesia looking forward to clinch the title for the 14th time, I guess. Yeah, 14th time next.
Next 14th time. I hope we can do it.
Thank you so much for talking to us.
Well, it wasn't the most insightful interview, if we're honest, but obviously there's a big week perhaps ahead here for Indonesia. Thomas Sugiarto giving a bit of a fright, straight games wins after that, but you have to admire, after 28 years in waiting, that Singapore came out and really showed some terrific spirit here in Delhi. 5-0, though, the final scoreline. Class told in the end. So that's the table as it stands. Thailand with their victory here this morning over Nigeria, also by 5-0. Obviously, it would be likely they are the two teams that come through and qualify for the quarterfinals here at the Thomas Cup 2014. So lots more to look forward to from the Siri Fort Sports Complex, but from Jim and myself, Richard, bye-bye for now.